Wow, 100,000 subscribers. That's you folks. Thank you very much for watching and for sharing, for commenting, and of course, for subscribing. And not just from me. All of us working on and with Java at Oracle are very thankful for your continued interest and dedication to Java and working hard to keep earning it. Now, where do I put this thing? You know there are magnets behind that thing right there.
Wow. This is not metal. Thank you, YouTube.
Welcome everyone to the Inside Java Newscast, where we cover recent developments in the OpenJDK community. I'm Nikolai Parlock, Java Developer Advocate at Oracle, and you gotta be strong today. Remember a while ago when I prefaced the episode on deprecating finalization with,
is it to give you a reason to stick with me through a topic that could otherwise be considered somewhat boring?
Well, six of you didn't think it was boring, and I'm banking this entire episode on that demographic, because we're discussing Javadoc. Because JDK 18 ships a feature that will be incredibly helpful for keeping documentation up to date. The Javadoc tool now allows you to make sure that code snippets in your docs compile and behave as expected, and you don't even have to build for Java 18. Are you ready for that? Then let's dive right in. First of all, who is this for? Just JDK devs and library maintainers? I disagree. While most of us aren't writing code for the whole world full time, most of us do write code for lots of colleagues at least some of the time. I think every class deserves at least a short paragraph of explanation of its central abstraction. Then the more users it gathers and the least trivial it is, the more important becomes a better explanation. And what better way to teach a more involved API than with a piece of code right there in the Javadoc. So that's what this is about. Embedding non-trivial code snippets in your docs while being sure that they can't get outdated without you noticing. Let's see how to do that. Say you're writing an API that you think can benefit from a good example in the Javadoc. Naturally, you're hesitant to put the code in the pre-tag because it's a hassle and chances are it will be outdated before you've even committed your changes. So here's what you do instead. First, you create a demo class in a tested source tree. Second, in that demo class, you write a test for your functionality. Third, you reference that test in your Javadoc with the new snippet tag. Let's go into a bit of detail on each step, starting at the end. The snippet tag accepts a few attributes that are expressed in simple key equals value pairs. The most important thing to configure is where to find your demo class, which you can do with class equals name of the class. Now, in order for the Javadoc tool to know where to look for these demo classes, you have to use the snippet path option with the path to the source tree you put the demo classes into. With these two ingredients, the class attribute in the snippet tag and the path as Javadoc command line option, you're getting your first results. The complete class is embedded in the Javadoc. That's a good first step, but clearly not ideal as it contains a lot of boilerplate. So let's use the second essential snippet attribute, region. Simply add region equals region name to the tag, then head over to your demo file and add two inline comments. On the line before the first you want to show in the docs, add start region equals region name. After the last line you want to show, simply write add end. There you go. Now just the juicy part shows up. That covers the third step. Now let's take a look at the second. Technically, you don't need to write tests, of course, just regular code suffices. But I think it's important to assert that the code actually does what the documentation claims. At this point, you might be wondering, why not just embed test code as snippets then? Fair enough, that would work as well. But remember that testing code and demonstrating code are not the same goal and they might interfere with one another. Case in point, where do you copy-paste your code from? Documentation and Stack Overflow or project test suites? We do all copy-paste our code, right? It's not just me, is it? Regarding step one, creating the demo class in a tested source tree, I won't go into how to set that up here because it depends on your build tool. But I did write a blog post on that I'll link in the description that explains how to set up a source demo Java folder in Maven so it gets compiled and tested. The snippet tag has a lot more to offer than what I described so far. You should check out JDK Enhancement Proposal 413 for all the details. Here are just some highlights. Your code can have highlights, pun fully intended. You can highlight substrings and regular expression matches in a single line or the entire region as bold, italic, or highlighted, which is customizable via CSS. You can replace text, for example, to cut something short within ellipses. You can link text like method calls or type names, again matching by substrings or regex, to the API docs. You can include other files than just Java sources. You can add HTML IDs, so URLs can link directly to a snippet. If you prefer readers of your source files to be able to see the snippets in line, you can forgo the entire external file shebang and just type out the code in the snippet without escaping the HTML entities, but with all the bells and whistles I just mentioned. But that brings you back to fragile examples, so there's one more option. Have the code in line and reference an external file, and if the two variants are not identical letter by letter, the Javadoc tool throws an error your way. Okay, that weren't just highlights, that's pretty much the whole list. But there are details to all of that, so definitely check out JEP 413. At the beginning, I also mentioned that you don't need to build for JDK 18 to use any of this. Just to make sure we're on the same page, you can generally build on a newer Java version than the source code and target platform require. The critical component here is the compiler, and the one shipped with JDK 18 can build from and for any version since 7. Ideally, all you need to do to make this work is set the compiler's release option to the desired version. So, for example, you can build your Java 8 or 11 project with JDK 17 or 18 and get all the build pipeline benefits from newer tool versions, like recent deprecation warnings. So if you're in Java 8, but have an eye on the Javadoc search bar, build your documentation with the JDK version 9 or newer, and you'll get it. Likewise, if you want to use these snippets, build your project on JDK 18 with the compiler's release flag set to the minimal Java version you're running on. If you also want to run your build on older JDKs, so for example 11, 17 and 18, that's a bit more tricky because the Javadoc tool from 17 and prior knows neither the snippet tag nor the snippet path command line option. The blog post I mentioned also explains how to work around this problem with Maven, so check that out if this is your requirement. And that's it for today on the Inside Java Newscast. Almost forgot to say Happy New Year for those of you who use the lunar calendar. If you have any questions about what I covered in this episode, ask ahead in the comments below. And if you enjoy this kind of content, help us spread the word with a like or by sharing this video with your friends and colleagues. The next episode will be hosted by my colleague Billy Corando, so I'll see you again in 4 weeks. So long!